my summer wasn't summer. Instead of late nights with friends, catching the sunrise on the coast, or going on nice long hikes to see the nicest view in the area, or driving around on open roads, I didn't go out. My summer, if I would describe it, was more so the air conditioner turned up to room temperature, a laptop connected to my monitor screen, and a lot of time spent with my own thoughts in an 11-by-8-foot room. I had this whole plan of making the summer the best that it could be, but at the same time, I had this plan of building the business I've always dreamed of building. The thing was, I couldn't have both. I couldn't have everything. So I had to choose. Everything in me wanted to go out and do crazy things with my friends. But every time I would feel the sense of guilt that I wasn't chasing what I really wanted. And so this brought the question to my head, has social media masked what I really wanted? Posting flashy photos, the highlights, our cars, our new Apple Watch, hanging out at the beach, looking like we're having a good time. Has social media ruined what I wanted deep down? Sometimes I question these things, because it's always a debate for me in my head. Am I doing this for the shot, or am I doing this because I want to? Ultimately, I knew what I wanted. I've always talked about it, no matter what. Every time someone asked me what I wanted to do, or what I wanted to be, or what I wanted to major in when I got to college, the answer was simple. I wanted to be whatever made me money. And in my head, I thought that was being an engineer, a nurse, something with math or science, because that's how we were raised to think. Math or science is where the money's at, right? But my thought was always, yeah, I'm gonna be this, I'm gonna be that, but then I'm gonna build a business around it. Every time I say that phrase, I'm gonna build a business, I feel like, yes, that is what I wanna do at the end of it all. The weeks leading into summer, I realized that this was the life I was going to live, at least for now. Staying in, learning, my back slumped, eyes fixed on the screen, filling my brain with seemingly endless amounts of information. Sleeping at a reasonable time, then waking up in the morning to do my usual routine. I would take out my phone, struggle to keep my eyes open, and scroll from app to app. First Instagram, then I would check Twitter, and then I would check Snapchat. I'd always see a timeline of what people did the night of while I was asleep. People were drinking, clubbing, munching out on some good food, laughing, you know, all the summer things that people had the time to do because the time was there for the taking. I'd feel a little bit left out. Jealous sometimes, but I thought if I wanted to be the CEO of my company, I had to act like one. I had to eat dirt, work late nights, and not have the leisure that I had last summer because the direction wasn't so clear. I didn't choose the summer that I had originally envisioned. Traveling, seeing new views of the world, booking plane tickets. I was supposed to book a ticket to California because my cousin told me that all I had to worry about was booking a plane ticket over there and he would take care of the food and the housing. What a deal! And I didn't take it. That is the summer I wanted, but I didn't let myself have. I would have endless debates on whether or not I'm doing the right thing. I would ask myself, is this even worth it? How are people enjoying their lives while seeming like they have everything? Financially, physically, mentally. Or maybe it was just an illusion. Because maybe the moment they log off, their insecurities come back. Or they're waiting on their next paycheck. Or maybe they're trying to scrap together some cash for the groceries the coming week. How have I had to work hours and hours and hours just sitting here on this desk trying to make life work? Thinking that if I put this extra hour in, or if I stay this one extra night in, I'll be in a good place to succeed. Too many times I've seen my peers or people around me put in half the effort and still get better results out of it. It all seemed super unfair. It all still seems super unfair. My experience this summer taught me one thing: reality. What are my goals, and what is the reality of me getting there? Of course, I always think about two things: film and entrepreneurship. I want to tell the best visual stories, but I also want to build a business I could be proud of. Do I want to film a journey as an entrepreneur? A journey filled with so much failure, so many emotions, so many mistakes, and at the peak of it all, the success? Or do I just want to paint a life full of highlights for the world to see? I don't know. There's this fine line I see between art and slapping something together just to put out into the world. I have this constant fight in my head, and I guess I'll never decide. I'm taking this time to say, I have no direction with this whole film stuff. The camera that I'm talking to, I'm just letting it take me. I don't know where I'll be tomorrow. I don't know where I'll be next week. And I don't know where I'll be years from now. But what I do know is that I'll always have a camera in hand. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys later.